The deal is sealed. The deed shall be done. That's right. It's time to make a pact with Faust. Today, I'm playing Faust in a Quetzal shell. Now, when building a Faust deck, you have two options. AI breakers are traditionally used as support breakers, such as Crypsis and with Artman in Prepaid K, for example, to support main breakers, because if you rely solely on AI breakers, you're going to have a lot of trouble with the likes of Swordsman, Turing, whatnot. But today, I'm going to play it in Quetzal, and that mitigates one of the biggest nemesis to AI, and that's none other than Wraparound. With Quetzal, I can now play Faust as my main breaker, and with this, I get all the advantages of only requiring one breaker out. Just like most Aether decks, I can afford to play it very aggressively. And I can actually explore design space that Aether will never ever get to do, and that is multi-access. You cannot play the Gorg and Maker's Eye with Aether because you access zero cards. With Faust, now you can. And so I'm going for a hyper-aggressive Quetzal deck. Well, that's a bit of a misnomer. This does need a bit of setup. You need to get a bit of money first, get your draw going, and get the Faust drawn and installed. But once you do, the legworks and Maker's Eye will lock down R&D and HQ like no other. I think it's a very strong mid-game deck, and we'll see how it works against HP Engineering in the future, who has a very strong mid-game as well. Obviously, you play Faust in Anarch, no other faction, because to play Faust effectively, you need constant good card draw, and no other faction has Wildside Adjusted Chronotype Infection. The only other way I can see you playing Faust as a main breaker outside of Anarch is in a game day deck, but that just makes it very slow. What's the point of playing Faust deck when it's slow? You want speed. Alright, very, very weird play here. I do not agree with this. When you see Quetzal on the other side of the table, you have to suspect Account Siphon. Lucky for him, I'm not playing Account Siphon, I'm playing multi-access. So I'm just gonna solidify my board state, get a bit of money, get some good liberated accounts on the table, and let him get his Eve campaign off. That I have to concede. Not too many choices there. But he is pretty poor after raising the Eve campaign. He's down to 3 credits. So unfortunately, my opponent makes a misplay here. He should try to guard his Eve campaign. Instead, I mean, guard as in having enough money to rest the eyes on the Eve campaign. But instead of doing that, he overcompensates by placing more eyes on his Eve campaign, eyes that he can never afford to rest. So my next line of play was very straightforward. Knowing that he probably couldn't rest anything of note on the remote server, I install my Imp and trash his Eve for free. So that crippled him big time. You must remember that I am Quetzal, so if you run Eli's or Nick Silvers, I'm not losing any tempo at all by running into your remote. So that's unfortunate for him there. The only thing that could realistically have saved him there was next bronze. Alright, so now that I've denied his economy, he is going to spend lots of turns setting up. I'm just going to play slightly aggressively here. Don't put myself too out of line. So I face check his R&D, he raises Eli, very good. It's something I can break with Quetzal's ability, so I jack out and run again with Maker's Eye. The main reason for running here is to use up my virus token on him before he decides to purge virus counters. And so I saw 3 cards. The first was an Adonis, which I trashed with my money. The second was a Nyx Silver. I trashed it because Quetzal doesn't like multi-sub barriers, but I have Parasite in hand. So that was a bad choice because the third card turned out to be a hedge fund. And I certainly would much rather deny his money than his eyes, because I can easily deny his eyes with Parasite. So a big mistake on my part. I should save the virus token to deny his hedge fund. I spend my entire next turn building up board state again. I should be drawing more cards at this point. It's a big mistake for me to go for money over cards, because I need Faust to threaten his remote. I do not want him to churn out agendas early, and that's one of the biggest weaknesses of this deck. Like, guys, you are pretty weak if you don't find, if you don't amass your breakers. So here I draw, I run R&D again. In case I can perform Maker's Eye run, it is the silver as I expected. No, I don't know where he got another silver from, but it doesn't matter. Again, as I said, the Parasite is there to save the day, and that silver is going to go down without much resistance. And this is where one strength eyes really suffer. I mean, instant tutoring Parasite at the start of your turn with Clone Chip or SMC is one thing, but just looking at this next silver, it's so pathetic. It's just going to die next turn. It didn't do anything at all. Well, too bad for him. So you look at his economy. It's doing very badly for ETF, but you can't really stop ETF. It is ETF after all. It's a workhorse of an ID. Sooner or later, he'll get his credits, and as long as he sensibly clicks for credits, he's not going to go anywhere. I'm not going to have free Maker's Eye runs, and he does something very smart here. He replaces the next silver. He knows he has enough credits to threaten any ice reds, so he's just going to install lots of cards and make me keep guessing. I can't safely play my Maker's Eye out to get a guaranteed 3-card access, and that really hurts because I really want to play aggressively early against HB, where the ice is pretty porous to me. So here I try to poke around, run his R&D to see if it's an ice that I can break with Quetzal's ability. Sure enough, it is. It's a Mother Goddess with Barrier subtype. So I allow him to get his server R&D secured. I'll attack it later. Now I'm going to run his remote, and I see the Marcus Betty. So the game plan is up. The jig is up. I know what he's doing. He's playing all the next ice and with Marcus Betty to fire off next goal. And I checked his remote on the last click, and well, he got me there. This was very good play for him, from him, and well played to my opponent on that. It's a Cyber Dex, honestly. He laid out the open. He knew I would trash it because I had an imp on the board. So knowing that, he places a Cyber Dex Spiral Suite there, so I would purge myself. He doesn't even need to rest the Spiral Suite. I'm doing his dirty work for him. So that's very bad, because you haven't seen my deck list, but there are only two imps. I really need the imps to trash the Eve campaigns, and they're all gone now. There is no recursion in this deck. This deck doesn't need recursion. All it needs is to get the files out, and once the Wildside engine is up, you just break every single ice with your Wildside cards. That's all you need to do. And you should win the game by the time you draw through your deck, because I'm running two Maker's Eyes, two Legworks, and I think two or three same old things as well. So with that amount of multi-access, if you don't win by the time you dig through all their cards, well, you deserve to lose anyway, because you're just that unlucky. Okay, he does get some money going. Do I contest it? No, I go for R&D. Why not? This is the problem when you don't have unrest eyes on R&D. So he allows me to get through. Well, admittedly, it's very hard to see that I can get through. I have no breakers on the board, but yet I'm able to get through with the magic of Quetzal, breaking through two barriers like their Swiss cheese. Once again, no agendas, no luck there. I can only reckon that he had all his agendas are stuck in his hand, which is a very good guess, considering that he has just been installing cards all this time. With no Jacksons, not scoring a single agenda, he must be flooded in HQ. I couldn't run HQ because I don't have a legwork in hand, although maybe I should have poked around after all. Okay, so now I'm constrained to 3 clicks thanks to Wildside, so now I'm just looking for files and adjust the chronotype right now. This is a very great deck to run Career Fair in. If you've seen my Regis main arena before, it's pretty good there with daily casts and liberator accounts, but it gets even better here because now you have Wildside and adjust the chronotype, which both cost 3 credits to install. Career Fair them in, and you're good. Yeah. Alright, so he continues getting set up, and this is the point where I sigh in frustration because he has reached his mid-game state where he can conceivably lock me out of every single server, and I, on the other hand, have not reached my mid-game board state yet. Just look at me, I'm so pathetic. No breaker, no adjusted chronotype, I'm running on 3 clicks a turn. This is awful. This is really bad. So I can just play cards from my hand and hope for the best at this point. Right now I'm just clicking for credit so I can play the sure gamble that I just threw. That's how bad it is. He rests an Eve and I know I can't contest it with all my imps gone. With imp it would be really great to run, but I'm afraid I just have to let his money go. And that is a very huge danger when running up against Marcus Betty next goal. The best line of play against Marcus Betty next goal is to deny the opponent's credits until they are on 9 or less credits. At that point, you can safely run any server because they won't be able to res next goal and play the Betty side game to trash programs or deal lethal net damage. He tries to go for an agenda score here, and I know my limits. There's no way I'm getting through that. And seeing the number of upgrades in that, I won't be surprised if he has a next go Betty combo to go. I'm not about to lose my cards right now, so I'm just going to money up. Money is not very useful for this deck, admittedly. When you're breaking ice with cards instead of credits, you much rather get the cards that you need. And I found one of them now, the Adjusted Chronotype. In the meantime, it scores an NAPD, which is fantastic. It's not something I want to steal. You can have your 2 points. I play Daily Cast, and I go for his economy. I know how important it is to win the economy war. You must at least make him feel uneasy about throwing agendas in their remote. At least make them think twice. Next goal is very expensive to res after all. Yes. You see the turntable that's been in my hand since turn 1. I don't plan on installing it this game. Turntable is there mostly because I know I will concede the early game, and that usually implies I give up an early Nisei Mark 2, an Astral Script, or an Overscored Atlas. Turntable is there to help me pull myself back in during the mid game, hopefully turn the tables around so that I can win the final dash to 7 agenda points. This deck is wants to rush to 7 agenda points in the mid game, where I have full reign over their servers with my AI Breaker. And now I'm there. I'm not there yet, actually. Nope. I haven't found my files yet. But since his R&D is so porous, since he neglected defending R&D, I'm just going to score the priority requisition. He can score his ABT. He's still in the lead, but, well, at least I'm not completely out of it. The ABT kind of misfired, and that looks good, but I cannot contest Archives because it's heavily guarded. Finally, there's the Faust, and you see why I need the credits. Having trashed Eve and played my Wildside Adjusted Chronotype combo, I'm down to 4 credits. I needed to hit Liberator twice before deciding what to do with my last 2 clicks. It's a tough choice here, because you do not want to discard cards at the end of your turn. I would like to install 2 cards from my hand right now so that I don't have to discard at the end of my turn, but I know that there's an Adonis sticking on the table and it's naked. You need to trash that. So I'm thinking of the best way to do it right now. I think my decision here was to install the Faust and trash the Adonis. I think that's the best play. I will only need to discard 1 card from my hand. So that exactly is what I do. Adonis goes into the bin, and now I've reached my mid-game state. So hopefully I can turn the tables around from here on out. As I was talking about turntable, it's useless this game. Ooh, I do not install the Faust. I YOLO into the server. Ooh, okay, this should be interesting. Oh, but he keeps me off the next bronze. Oops. Yeah, I was the reason I YOLO into the server, I knew he could probably do Marcus Betty at next goal, but I wanted to force that out, force him to use it, basically. Knowing that he has no programs of value to trash. As I was saying, turntable is irrelevant this game. It's useless against HB because swapping their agendas is rather useless, and they usually score their 2-pointers before their 3-pointers, like this guy smartly does here, to avoid a lethal turntable. Okay, let's have some fun. I'm going to YOLO into the server once again. Breaking next bronze with 2 redundant cards from my hand. I know the Marcus Betty combo is about to be unleashed on me, and sure enough, there it is, the next goal. 4 next ice res, that's 4 trash programs, 4 net damage. We play the side game. Now, here I do a very smart thing. I know that from digging his R&D that he plays Ash, and that upgrade in the server is probably an Ash. I know he requires 2 credits to res the Ash, so I know he would bid 0, hence I bid 0 as well. Because if he bid anything more than 0, he wouldn't be able to res the Ash to keep me out of the agenda. Next step, firing off the next goal. I can break it for 2 cards in my hand and an E3 feedback implants. But what cards do I trash? I need the Mimic to break Architect, I've seen that in his R&D. I need the Spoon to break the next bronze. If I trash my 2 I've had worse, they won't be useful. That's useless. And it'll still cost me 1 credit. Why don't I suffer the consequences of next goal? I lose my Faust, my second Faust. I still have 1 more Faust in my deck. I lose my entire hand. But I will draw into 6 cards, most likely seeing my third Faust, and more importantly, accelerating my game. So there you go. Boom. 6 cards. And sure enough, the third Faust was there. So I get through the server without having to pay a single credit, and I survive the next goal. And that was my insurance plan. Even if Marcus Betty does fire on me, if he chose 4 net damage, I would draw into 6 cards. I would win. I will come out ahead. If he treasures programs, I only lose my Faust, so that's great. Of course, I accessed the face down card first in case it was an NEPD. Sure enough, it was. This means that I spent all my credits to beat the ash trace, steal the NEPD, no credits left to trash ash. Bad luck for me. Zero link runner, that's the downside. Not much I can do about that. But hey, at least I stole the agenda that would put him at match point. Now I'm on match point. Any agenda wins me the game. I have money, I have daily cast, but it's time to take a break. So, yep, I can't run this turn. I need to install my files first. But once I have files installed, I can run anywhere because I don't really need credits to break ice. I just need to trash cards from my hand, the useless cards. Adjusted Chronotype and Wildside are useless. Parasite can be come in handy. I've had worse at this point, it's irrelevant. I can trash it with files as well. For those of you wondering at home with the interaction, files trashing I've had worse does not trigger the I've had worse draw. This is why I... Whoa there, son. Game just got hard. Game was good. Oh my gosh. Word. He just read 18 credits worth of ice. 18 credits. I ran archives here because he fired ABT just now and it fizzled. Two cards went to the heap, but there was nothing to be had. So yeah, things just got a lot harder. HQ is a viable option when he's poor, but I haven't found either of my two legwoods yet, so that's out of the question. So right now I'm just gonna see his R&D while he's down, while he's poor. I break next bronze for 3 cards, I break next Mother Goddess for using Quetzal's ability, and I click through Eli and I win the game. Goodness me, that could have ended very, very badly. The Toll Wolf was killer. And thank goodness he decided to ice up his remote instead of R&D. So I think this game gives you a good sense of how this deck wants to play out. It's all about quality runs, making sure that every run counts because your ID ability only triggers once per turn and Faust is limited by the amount of ammo you have in your deck. When you dedicate 8 out of 15, that's more than half of your influence, to Mega Digging, Events, Legwork and Maker's Eye, you know that this is serious stuff they are looking to do. Obviously, Christian Grid is the natural counter, but otherwise, you can see that the R&D accesses I got this game were roughly par for the cost, and that's how you win. With the number of accesses I got, I should have gotten 5 agenda points, which is enough, because the other 2 agenda points came from the remote, which I ran, which he failed to defend. So money makes the world go round, it's no surprise, it applies to every deck, this one inclusive. Even though Faust takes no credits, you still need to have a stable economy, which is why I borrowed the money engine over from my Regis Reyna deck. I mean, since you're running Career Fest, why not? I needed a lot of money this game. It wasn't that obvious, but when you are constantly trashing their campaigns, when you're trying to beat the Ash Trace for 4, when you're stealing NAPDs for 4, and when you're playing your run events, your Maker's Eye for 2 credits apiece, it's actually a lot of money, and that's not counting all the setup overhead that I had. So this deck actually takes quite a while to set up, and it's actually considered a rather slow deck in the early game. Just like your typical guy's deck, it really shines in the mid game. But until then, you really do struggle, and as you saw, I had to concede the first agenda. Had that been an Adonis campaign, maybe ABT that fired off, or even a Pyrex that fired off, things could have been way different. And I think you have to agree with me that after testing with this game, Quetzal is the correct ID to play this with. First reason, you're much less reliant on Faust for getting through servers. As you notice, in my final R&D run, I only needed 3 cards to break the next bronze, which was admittedly annoying, but I could have done the same with David, but I tossed away my David to the net damage, so that was a pity. Otherwise, it would have cost 0 cards from Faust because I broke the Mother Goddess with Quetzal's ability and Eli's Amaroid, which I can click through for 1 click. Don't forget, I'm running E3 feedback plants. E3 works so well with Faust because the biggest blind spot of Faust is multi-sub ice, so real ice would be very annoying, but I have Parasite to deal with that, and of course E3 feedback implants deals with that as well, which means I need more money. Again, money makes the world go round. So Quetzal is a very, very natural choice of an ID because you already want E3 feedback implants to synergize with your IED ability. Why not go all the way by playing Faust as well? And from there, you can see how my deck building process when it was only natural to turn to Maker's Eye and Legwork for my influence choices, because when you're making such power runs, you want them to be as impactful as possible, and nothing gives more impact than Maker's Eye and Legwork for the influence cost. And finally, I'd like to talk about Imp, which was the main highlight for my early game. It is really played because it's infection. It's not the best card in the world, but it sings Anarch, and it really helped me out in the early game. Disruptions everything because I'm running a slow deck in the early game. In the early stages, I can't really threaten, so it's all about that Imp to make sure they don't run out of control with Res Pack campaigns, with Sundews and whatnot. Unfortunately, I misplayed in this game. It could have been way more disruptive had I chose to trash the pack, the hedge fund instead, and had I not accessed the Cyberdex via Suite. But hey, you live, and you learn. And of course, a very good reason why you run it in this deck is because you don't need the memory. The only real card that you need to install, Program rather, is Faust, which takes up one memory. Three free slots to play with, four if you install Turntable, so Imp is a natural include as well. So I would like to say that this is a pretty powerful deck, but of course it has to fight against the tier 1 archetypes to really tell. But I think this is the best way to play a Faust-centric, a deck that's centered on Faust as the main breaker. There's another possible route. You could play the Account Siphon way, as Dan D'Argenio mentioned on SteamHack, on SteamHack Skype. You should join it if you haven't. It's a very good place to talk strategy. One of the best combos that you can do early on with Andromeda is install Faust, straight away Account Siphon. That is devastating. First turn Account Siphon, knowing that you can almost certainly get in with your 7-card hand. Amazing stuff. Gotta try that out. Thanks for watching and happy net running. Goodbye.